In response, Jones's attorney, Tyrone Blackburn, told USA Today, "Litigation should never be the first option for a dispute. We filed because of the refusal to negotiate on the other side." Interestingly, Jones has implicated other celebrities in his lawsuit, alleging that they were part of Diddy's supposed criminal enterprise. One of the names mentioned is Cuba Gooding Jr. Jones recently amended the lawsuit to include Gooding, claiming the actor made sexual advances toward him. According to the suit, Diddy facilitated this encounter by introducing Jones to Gooding and then leaving them alone in a studio on a yacht. The lawsuit details that Gooding began touching and groping Jones, including his legs, upper inner thighs, lower back, and shoulders. Jones had initially accused Gooding of assault in a lawsuit filed in February, but only recently added him as a formal defendant. Cuba Gooding Jr. has faced similar allegations in the past. In 2019, he was investigated for allegedly forcibly touching a woman on the rooftop. Mom, of the
Lord. Well, let me introduce you to my mom, called Mom Dukes.
Hi.
She's getting a drip with me. She's hydrating. What's up, Mom?
Everything's good, baby. I'm here with you.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
What?
Mom, freshly dipped though. I was just trying to show you the shoes. Feeling like I have a good time. Ain't sitting in the house playing. Yeah. Outside moving and shaking, baby. She come with me to strip club. I don't care. Real. It's my dog. You know, I want to live life. We out here moving and grooving. So my mom told me, she just said, keep moving, baby.
That's right.
Keep moving.
She don't stop.
She could touch the floor with her palms.
What?
You know?
Flat.
Flat.
It's God's side and the other side. And we don't care nothing about the other side. Period. Period. All of these big dick deviants is all catching hell in 2024. It's up for all of them. It don't matter if you Diddy or whoever you is. T.G. Jakes, any of them. All lies will be exposed.
Man, you doing it, man. You deserve it, daddy. You putting in that work. Proud of you. I love you.
I appreciate it.
Yeah.
For all those in London that don't know what happens to the white man when he comes to a P. Diddy party, this is what happens to the white man.
It's so unfortunate.
You gotta pull back though, so they can see. That's crazy. Matt, move out the way. You're still alive.
Puff and Usher did have a situation. And that situation led Usher to the hospital. Now, I let Usher explain that to y'all. I let Usher tell that story. But how dare you say a man that groomed you, you gonna give him a pass? Bro, you know I know. Puff had Kim in the room. Had one of Keith Sweat's baby mothers in the big room outside the master bedroom. He came outside in his robe. He came outside in his robe. She gave him a fellatio right there. His back was turned to me. She gave him a fellatio. You knocked on the door. I came and opened the door for you. Puff went in the room. You came in the room and kissed that girl dead in the mouth.
What? You said, I like when you do it like that, daddy, when you scrambling and scraping for shit.
Hey, man.
They sacrificed and did it. They said, nigga, you got to take this shit because we can't be involved. But Diddy smart. He filmed every fuck session. So he was fucking Clive and the motherfucking freak boy that run Universal Music Group. So he got them on some fuck tapes. Now that's why they raided the house, because they got friends in Homeland Security and the feds. And they said, get in there and get them tapes from this nigga. He trying to blackmail us. That's what I believe is going on.
Just right now, he's having 48 hours with Diddy, him and his boy.
they're having the times of their lives, like the, you know, where we hanging out, a 15-year-old's dream.
Look at Justin.
You know, I have been
deer in headlights. Mind you, Diddy is 40 years old in this, and Justin is 15.
Given custody of him, you know, he signed to Usher.
I'm signed to Usher.
I had legal guardianship of Usher when you know, he did his first album. I did Usher's first album. Yeah. I don't have legal guardianship of him, but for the next 48 hours, he's with me. So, we gonna go full. Buck fool crazy.
Does he have you doing any chores? Are you doing dishes at all? I mean, to keep you humble somewhat? Or are you just like, can you stay up till 4 in the morning with them and party?
I mean, I could. I actually stayed up longer than them.
Do you have money? What's going on?
I mean, I had like per diem. Yeah. Uh-huh. I had like, you know,
what
like
a
living.
Life.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
14 years old. You're a dad now. Would you ever send your kid to Puffy Camp?
Hell no.
And then maybe that. If they knew there was going to ever be a YouTube, or they knew there was going to ever be social media, a lot of the stuff probably wouldn't have got played out like it did and stuff like that. Because they gave him a brown paper bag. When they gave him a brown paper bag, he was just putting stuff in there. So I said, damn, you know, he got to go put it on the counter and, you know, show everybody what he's getting. So as he's going, I'm just looking at the places where he's picking stuff from. So there's one part he picked up some things from up here on my left side. He put them in the bag. So when I went by there and I looked up there, and it said butt plugs. And I was like, hey, yo, I was messing with him. Because people don't understand, you know, we was like friends. He was a part of the same gang. So I'm still going to tease him. I'm still going to mess with him and everything like that. I could do that. It wasn't just no security thing. So I say, yo, what are you getting this for? And it said butt plugs. And he was like, yo, can I do my shopping by myself? I said, yeah, you can do it by yourself, brother. He didn't even have to show the guy nothing. He just gave the guy a wad of money. I mean, like, he gave the guy a stack, something like this. And Puff wasn't a dude to carry no 20s and no 50s and nothing like that. And I mean, like, he just said, boom. And we walked out the store. So we had to leave Atlanta and go to North Carolina for a show. You understand? And it was him, this rapper, Sarah, and this other girl. We all got on a G5 jet, and we flew to G4 jet, and we flew to North Carolina. And stuff like that. Like, yeah, so then... Next thing you know, somebody rang the doorbell. We had the presidential suite where we was at. So I opened the door, and the dude said, yo, I'm here for my cousin. I said, who your cousin? And he said, Ja Rule. I said, well, he busy right now. He said, he busy doing what? I said, he with Puff. They're in the room. They busy. They don't want to be bothered. He said, well, I'm going in there. I said, bro, you ain't going in there, because he told me they don't want nobody to be bothering them. And he was like, yo, I don't care, man. I'm going in there. That bull like that. I said, yo, bro, Jesus Christ, I had to come down here and take the air out of my body before you get in that room right there. Watch. He tried to bum rush me. I grabbed his and threw him against the piano. When I threw him into the piano, Puff and Ja Rule runs out the room. Puff got his towel, Ja grabbing his towel, but they butt the naked. And so then Ja was like, yo, what's going on? Yo, Gene, that's my cousin. He know me well. You know, and Puff was like, yo, Gene, what happened? I said, he tried to get in the room. I told him he couldn't get in the room. And he was like, Puff looked at Ja. He said, yo, Ja said, you ain't want to go in that room because there's a lot of freaky going on. Bro, when Ja said, you don't want to come up in there, a lot of freaky stuff is going on. You got to use your mind. What they was doing with those butt plugs.
Right. Hi, I'm Alexander. I'm 6'8" and weigh 240 pounds. I like roasted whole turkeys.
Ooh, baby, do you know that's what? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth. Heaven, love comes first. We'll make heaven our place on earth.
All the praises and the honor goes to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Recha HaKodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and bishops for great millstone honors as well to you, brethren, all you supporters and believers of this ministry and this truth. Shalom to the hopefully elect, shalom to the elect. So anyway, I did a long enough intro. It was not enough clips to put in there to describe these situations and how everything that some Israelites were exposing. I remember back in 2006, it was these two Jakes, and they knew they was Israelites, but they kind of went off on doctrine, obviously. But they was exposing a lot of that and what was going on, and then all the videos was taken down. And then it was all considered conspiracy, you know, so forth and so on. But you see now, the internet has broken out and start exposing everything. And then you see Cat Williams, who was more so of a credible witness than people like us, you know. And there you have it. You know, what can we say? All of it's in there. I'll just read a few scriptures. There's not much more for me to say. But I will say, if I can remember, they was talking about the parties, and they, it was another clip I didn't put in, how he was giving them drinks and they passing out, and they would record them and have them in evidence. You know, this has been going on, right? And I also say that there's higher people above them. You know, our so-called black people, right? So-called. We're going to take the fall for everything. And we know the people high up in this boule that set them up, right? They're the ones who probably did things to him and pass it on down. Then Michael Jackson. And you see how Michael Jackson and Prince, all of them died kind of broke. Now, I knew a guy in the industry, right? And there's different levels to the industry. Some people don't, you know, on the low levels you don't know much of. But when they sign them big contracts, you got to go through them parties and them shopping sprees, you know, that's influence, right? Just like you go to jail, people buying you stuff. You don't let nobody buy you anything in prison, man. So anyway, Floyd Mayweather had parties with Justin Bieber, and they had contracts there. Whatever you saw, you couldn't disclose your contracts, right? So yeah, this, that Howard Stern, I think I put that clip in there. They all know what's up, man. That Charlemagne the God, yeah. Why do you think he's sitting up there? And them women know too, right? Judge Mathis, it's all being exposed about him and those same rituals at the, I believe at the Diddy parties, right? But it's also came out that he goes that way too. And the wife is telling it. So this is why they never stay married long, right? You saw that Oscar De La Hoya and Pumps and everything else. And when you get up into that, Professor Griff used to speak on that. When you get up onto that high level like that, yeah, you done took the bag. You know, and don't think they haven't gotten to Israelites. They've gotten all the churches, right? So, you know, they want their hand in everything, because if they have their hand in anything, they can control the narrative, right? They can control what you say and so forth and so on. So anyway, let me get a scripture real quick. Luke 8 and 17. It says, I'll try to make this quick. Luke 8 and 17. For nothing is secret that shall not be made manifest. Neither thing anything hid that shall not be known and come abroad. Right? So nothing is in secret. All these things is being shown. Remember, before it was all conspiracy. We talk about that mark in Revelation 13. You know? That mark, the RFID, right? We talk about that. And they take it down and say it's the same thing. But as we can see, all these things that we've been speaking on and showing, and even people that's not really prophets, they expose it because they was there. And like I said, if I didn't say it, I knew a guy that was in the industry who was a musician, a couple of them, and they all on drugs. But the things they had to do, or the things that they set them up to do, they don't force them to do it, they set them up. And he said it was tables in those parties that could go for like a half a block in those big mansions. and there's every drug you want on that table, and they coerce you to take them. Or they'll put it in your drinks, and then once you get tipsy enough, then you'll do the other drugs. Yeah, we know what happened to Whitney Houston and the rest of them. Right? Now when you look back at Marvin Gaye and I think his father and, you know, all of it. First of all, this ain't nothing new. And then this man, P. Diddy, Andre Harrell, but it goes really back to, not Clive Davis. Who's the other one? Barry Gordy? You know, they got to go through levels in this Boulé thing, man. Right? They got to go through levels. And then it goes even on a higher level, right? What's his name? What's his name? Liar Cohen? You know, it's probably some things we can't even say in this video, but you know who he was, obviously. When you hear particular names, yeah. And, you know, all this stuff that they talk about us and how we're this particular type of group and we don't like certain nationalities, we don't like people, and we all, you know, it's easy to say love your oppressors when the oppressor is the one oppressing you, you know what I'm saying? So there's a lot I can't say in this video, but you know, a lot of people will say, the Christians will say, well, those are the people of the Bible, right? But you see what's happening. What oppression is they going through, right? It says, I'm going to read a little bit on this, man, that helped Diddy. He claims he's backing out and said he didn't really do anything and he don't remember him, right? This man is, he's been involved in hip-hop for 30 years, Def Jam. Oh, yeah, came out by LL Cool J. Yeah, M2. Tony Newman exposed him and what he likes, and this other guy that everybody like listening to. I can't remember his name. He's in the same predicament. He's doing the same thing, but he messed with the horogenous spirits. Let me say that. I can't remember his name right now off the top. But Def Jam Records, Warner Music, Entertainment, it goes on and on. I'm not gonna say much about it. Yeah, you know what it is. Oh, Kevin Gates, yeah. Is people coming out saying that they done had him too. Meek Mills, Method Man, and the list goes on. Leaked tapes. Yeah, Ecclesiastes 12 and 14. For God shall bring every evil work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. The Lord is not playing, man. He's showing the hand. He's showing you. And this is, you know, I thank the Heavenly Father. You know, we pray for things. We pray for protection, you know, to be healthy and continue doing His ministry and stay faithful. But I'm also thankful that he didn't have us into that. Now when you look back at it, you know, I know people that was going in that direction. They're thankful now that they never joined up with that. You know, Matthew 16:26. For what a man profit if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Really means his own life. Because he can't lose his soul. It all belongs to the Heavenly Father. And understand that the Lord is the one that gave him up. Romans 1:26. A lot of Christians, I'm going to jump there to that direction because they have a problem with us Hebrew Israelites and what we speak and what we teach, but we teach the Bible the right way. They all think it's Satan, you know? Yeah, but God is in control of all of that. That's what a lot of people don't understand. The Most High is not that white man with stringy hair with a bed sheet and sandals, right? Doesn't work that way. Let's get Psalms 49 and I'll close it. It says, where am I at? Wherefore, 49:5, wherefore should I fear the days of evil when the iniquity of the heel shall come compass me about? They that trust in their wealth and boast themselves in the multitude of their riches, right? None of them can by any means redeem his brother, nor give God a ransom for him. For the redemption of their soul is precious, and it ceases forever. So let's go to another translation so you get more understanding on that. 49:8. Let's get the NIV. Right? Let me get the NIV. Let's get the NLT. NIV. 49:7. No one can redeem the life of another or give God a ransom for them. The ransom is for life is costly. The ransom for a life is costly, and no payment is ever enough. The only way out is blood out. Blood in, blood out. Nothing else you can do about that, man. Right? That he should still live forever and not see corruption. For he seeth the wise men die, likewise the fool and the brutish person perish, and leave their wealth to others. Right? So this is no new thing under the sun. Just like Solomon, when he got older, he worshipped Chemosh and Molech. All these are the same gods of the sacrifices, man. They go in, they the part of the ritual, and then the other part, the sexual part, comes afterwards. It's not so much about the sexual part. It's the other parts you got to do. And then when you turn yourself, and you can believe in any religion you want. You can be a Hebrew Israelite if you want. But as long as you relinquish the authority to Satan, then you good to go. And they give you everything you want. And the biggest trick about it is they will make you believe that even though you did that, that God still loves you. Real talk. Guess who Sean Puffy P. Diddy, which Diddy means nipples, guess what religion he is? He's a newfound Christian in 2016. This is a Christian man. Yeah. That's all I have on that. Shalom.